We are lucky enough today on Good Things Utah to have the number one plus chess player in Utah, the nation, and the world for his age group, 11-year-old Kayden Troff. Glad you're here, Kayden.
Hi.
All right, so you're 11. You started when you were 3. Tell us how you started playing chess.
When I was 3, I just used to sit on my dad's lap. And I thought it was pretty cool because, I mean, I just sat there and watched.
You have big brothers, too, right?
Yeah. And my dad wanted to play them because he didn't really have any to play. So I just played my brothers and I just was watching. And I don't remember at all, but my mom said one day I just asked to play a game. So I just sat and played a game.
And you've been playing ever since?
Yeah.
How often do you practice?
I practice, let me see, I wake up in the morning and I run with my dad. And then I do about 2 hours of chess. And then I do school thing, or I do my school.
That little school thing.
That school thing.
Mm-hmm.
Gets in the way sometimes.
And then after school, you're playing?
Yeah, then after school, I do another 2 hours. And then getting kind of at night, I do some more.
I want to know what their reaction was when you're this young kid and you start beating your brothers and your dad. When did they know you were kind of a big deal?
I think it was, we didn't start playing in tournaments at all. I think I was 6. And then that's when we kind of started getting more serious about it. And so I was chosen for to represent the United States.
Good for you. How's it feel when people swarm you? Because they get mm-hmm. freaky over Kayden because he's so good when you go to these chess
Do you sign matches? Autographs sometimes?
Not much, but yeah, I've done it.
He's humble. 7-year-old Kayden Troff, so happy you were here. Will you let us know how you do in Mazatlan?
Sure.
Okay, good luck. Okay, if I do this, what are you going to do?
I'm going to challenge your move.
Okay.
And you lose.
And you lose. We'll be right back, everybody.
This is the largest chocolate project we've ever done. I don't think we can get much bigger than this.
What about a chocolate cityscape? What about a chocolate limp?
I think the chess set weighed over 1,500 pounds, 32 chess pieces, and 64 chocolate squares. That's a lot of chocolate. I hope the chess kids like the chocolate.
What kid doesn't like chocolate?
True.
You guys are all excited, and we're excited too. And if you knew what was behind this curtain, you would be even more excited. Yay! But before we do that, I want to introduce you to the Hatches, and they probably have the best job that anyone could have. Katie and Steve get to work with chocolate all day long. Yeah. Kayden, I want you to know that this is for everything that you've done and all the hard work you've put in. In October, he will represent the United States. He'll go to the World Youth Championship. Yay! Secondly, everything behind that curtain is chocolate. Everything you can eat.
Chess kids were quiet.
But seriously, I got plowed over by those suckers.
They play to win.
Everything's edible. That's awesome.
Oh, yeah, those chess pieces were magnificent. It looked so cool, didn't it?
They're so huge. Those kids were bear hugging the chocolate pawns. They were grabbing those suckers and not letting anybody else take them.
This game is an art form.
It's all about endurance.
Never underestimate your opponent.
It's a battle.
It's a battle.
It's war.
We
are the countries of the
elite.
Only the strong survive.
The clock is ticking.
The title is at stake.
One move.
It's all it takes.
It's only you.
It's only you.
Your opponent.
And the board.
Let's do it.
My name is Kayden Troff. I'm from West Jordan, Utah, and I'm 14 years old. Right now, I'm number one for my age, number nine under 21, and number 69 in the nation. Yeah, I actually keep track of that pretty closely, so. One of the funnest things I tell people is they're like, oh, after a chest tumor, I bet you're so tired. What do you do after that? Like, I play more chess. No matter what rating, no matter what age, you have the chance to be a champion.
Championship and 2013 U.S. Women's Championship. This year marks the fifth consecutive year that each of these prestigious events has been held in St. Louis. In honor of the five-year anniversary, the 2013 U.S. Chess Championship will feature a 24-player Swiss and a prize fund of more than $180,000. Champion.
My goal is to be the top senior in the tournament. No, I don't. There's some of these kids I don't even never even heard of, so it'll be interesting. I'm sure. I see the list. It's new prodigies are coming up every hour. No, I don't mind losing to somebody up to here, but somebody this low, that's cruel and unusual punishment. Age against youth, the eternal battle.
A lot of delays, finally here in St. Louis, but it's going to be a great time going to a tournament that many great players have played at, and my first time, so hopefully I can make my mark like many before me have.
People say, is it stressful? I have no idea. It's nothing like football or basketball. It's a lot worse.
It goes a lot slower.
No, it's not that. It's the... You know, in basketball, it's like the whole team decides who wins or loses. Chess, it's just your set.
Different.
Because I'm low rated, they're high rated, I'm young, they're old, they have some sort of expectation, I don't. So all the pressure's on them. So I was like, okay, I'm just gonna come in and have a great time, and it should be
cool. Playing in his first U.S. championships and trying to figure out what it takes to hang with the big boys.
I want the chance to play some of these other great players that I've been able to watch over the years. Just preparing for Strapunsky. Finding his games, looking at what lines he plays, and then looking at the different files depending on what I saw from his games.
You know, I discovered after lots of tournaments of going with him that, you know, I have a very specific job to make sure everything in his environment is as much at home to him as possible, make sure he's eating well, make sure he looks good. And so, you know, that's kind of my job, to keep everything as close. He is a homeboy. He likes to be home, even though that might be surprising since he travels so much, but if we can keep things as much like home as possible, then he does much better in his play. So I do, you know, I always say that I probably understand chess better than any other player that doesn't play the game. As Kayden tells me, Mom, you can't completely trust a computer because computers will make computer moves and not necessarily human moves. And so I put it in, and if he's down, then I get panicked, but then if I don't put it in, then I worry that I don't really know because it's high-level chess, and so, yeah, there's a lot of pacing that goes on.
I was feeling, like, pretty confident and that I would get the opening that I decided I was going to play.
Going into the game, I was feeling kind of nervous. It's always hard for me going into the tournament because, you know, you just want to be able to sit down and just play the game. Once the tournament starts, I start feeling a lot better. Before the game, I'm just trying to go through what I prepared and just as the game starts, hope it all pays off.
All right, we'd like to start round one. As the sound of the bell, please wait and may start the clock.
Yeah, I'm winning this, but it's always hard. You never know if you're going to mess up, what tricks are going to happen. So I'm like, yeah, I probably have this, but it's so hard to tell.
It was a tremendous game from start to finish, an epic fight. It went all of 64 moves, but in the end, Kayden played this move, h4. He got two passed pawns marching down the board, played this move, h3 to h2 with check, and Strapunsky had to resign because after moving his king, Kayden would have played the move knight to f2, a tremendous move, brilliant move, preparing to queen this pawn, and that would have been unstoppable. So Strapunsky decided it was too much and resigned. A big start for a 14-year-old, had to be one of the youngest players to win even a game in the championship.
So first U.S. championship, first game, done with a successful result.
We celebrate with orange juice. There you go. Great win today. Taking on Gavitt tomorrow. Oh, you're gonna get a lot? Yeah. What?
I'm thirsty.
Thank you.
a lot of exciting guests from out of town, and one in particular, the young grandmaster, Kayden Troff, and he's outside with Taryn.
Wonderful.
Yes, thank you, Jen. I'm here with Kayden and his mother, Kim. Now, Jen just introduced you as a grandmaster. How does that sound?
It sounds pretty good to me. I mean, they can just keep it. So, I don't know. It makes a difference when it's something you've worked really hard for, and, you know, that's what you look up to most of your life, is these guys that are GMs, and all of a sudden it's like, oh, I am one. So, it's a pretty good feeling.
I can only imagine. And you're only 16, and you had a big summer becoming a grandmaster and winning the Junior U.S. Championships right here at the Chess Club of St. Louis.
Thank you, Taryn and Kayden and Kim. What a wonderful interview.
I seem to recall that Kayden, by the way, not just a grandmaster, but a former world champion. I believe he won
under 14.
He won the gold medal and was world champion. So, I mean, even though he's 16, international grandmaster, he's a veteran. He's played all over the world.
He was on the cover of Chess Life with Gary Kasparov.
For that world championship
one.
Yeah, very impressive. So, really, shout out to Kayden. We're very proud of him.
been struggling to make things right. That's how a superhero learns to fly.